Today, I think I just tried to compare four different kind of instruments, and because my job is for recording sessions, studio, I'm a studio recording musician, so I do a lot of recordings. So my experience probably I can share with you, and also from my knowledge to research the instruments and my practice, that I like, you know, to try different kind of instruments, and so I can share all this kind of experience to you. Okay, first instrument that I want to talking about, actually before I already show you this newly innovated instrument, it's kind of three changing instrument, and basically it's kind of Erhu, yeah, kind of new design, beautiful design, and the designer also used guitar packs, and it's easy to tune in the strings, and also this part just like a drum pad, so it can replace, and in case the string is broken or you want to use artificial string. Okay, that's a real Python string on the string. So you can see, you know, they are different, but today through the compared different kind of instruments, you heard different sound, what I produced the sound. Okay, now this instrument to me is very brand new, and I tried to use it for my recording, but from the sound, it depends from the bridge to the, what we call the real sound, and also changing to make different distance. Of course, shortest sounds high, sounds like we call it modern art called Erquan, Erhu. Erquan is especially for Moon Reflect and the Second Spring, that piece, Erquan Yin Yue. Okay, this design kind of combined with Zhonghu, Erquan Erhu and the regular Erhu together. Of course, because it's not, you know, the skin is not, you know, glued on the resonator directly. It's used the frame. So sounds probably not good enough as the traditional style, but I already suggested to the maker, designer, I said probably the leaking from the connection, because they put some three pads, I can feel the sound probably is come out. If we don't have the special metering, you know, to check the sound, of course you can't tell. Okay, that's a regular Erhu. Because the changing is a lot of like regular Erhu, traditional Erhu use the thread string to around the strings. That means when you pressure strings, the changing will be loose a little bit. So, but this one, you are directly touched with the hardwood. So like when you play this, just like another Chinese instrument, the banhu. So you can feel the string is tight, not the regular one. Second, and also the space. Because the space, you can't adjust it because it already fixed. Because the designer want to have the 13 position to get the, you know, the right pitch immediately, like this. Can change keys immediately, and anyway, this kind of design is convenient for touring musicians. You know, if I, you know, I tour to somewhere, maybe one instrument already, you know, good enough to replace another three instruments, and also the soundbox, the resonator, is old styles overshot an erhu. So I measured the wide is 10 centimeter, the high is I think it's A in centimeter. Yeah, so A by 10. So the skin side, okay, the skin side, not including the frame. And for the sound, the bridge is very important. So you can try different kind of bridge. And if the skin is very thick, yeah, maybe you can find some bridge, can make a bright sound. That is used high. But and also the strings, it's tunable. That means you can adjust to pitch. Usually I turn the string sound to pitch A. Yeah, if you want to a little bit soft, you can turn like G sharp. Yeah, A is perfect. So most erhu you can check the sound around the A. Yeah. And also, different kind of instrument, when you play it, it depends on what kind of bow, what kind of string distance to make sound. When you play all kind of string instruments, I think the sound is similar. It depends on that instrument's resonator, because all the instruments that the resonator are different. And also, the string distance different. So depends the distance of the string and the resonator size and the bow, the weight of the bow to make the right sound. Okay, that's the instrument, you know, I want to talk is from Mr. Ma. You know, it's kind of extended in the range instrument. And also this instrument, when you someday, you know, you can find it, would be perfect that you can, you know, replace, you know, different kind of instrument. A secret I don't want to tell you, you know, this changing is removable. Listen, they have a trunk. That means you can adjust the pitch from here, yeah, if in the octave tone, yeah. So that's very smart design. You can't see the details, but I can show you they have a track on the top. That means the two changing can, you know, up or down, you know, to adjust the pitch. Okay, let me compare another instrument. Okay, let me, before I change another one, let me measure the string. The lower the string, it's about 54 centimeter, and to the arch end, it's about 46, and it's, for the regular erhu string distance is about almost 41, yeah. So the distance is a standard, yeah, standard. Okay, let me change to Zhonghu, yeah, Zhonghu. Of course, Zhonghu, the string from the changing to the bridge, doesn't like you know, the extended the QIN erhu, and this one from bridge to the changing is the same as erhu. Yes, 40, almost 41. Yeah, but the difference is the sound box is bigger. The resonator size is 10 and a half by 10 and a half, yeah. When I traveled in China, I tried to buy another Zhonghu. I test, probably it's brand new, you know, the sound is not ready. You know, usually you need to practice more and I can make sounds good. Now this Zhonghu I used for the episode, the Legend of Korra. So whole albums and a whole episodes, I played you this instrument, and I like it very much. The, unfortunately, this instrument a little bit cracking here, so make the sound a little bit negative. Yeah, and I fix it, but still cause the skin a little bit losing. You know, but sounds still very good. Sounds great. I love it. Okay, that's the Zhonghu. You know, Zhonghu probably you can find on the eBay, Amazon, and Alibaba. You know, you can find this kind of instrument, depending what kind of instrument you can find. And it's just a sound. Some people say, oh, okay, I want to save some money to buy a cheaper one. Of course, the cheaper instrument is not good enough materials to make the instrument from skin to the wood. So better quality sounds also good. I tried to buy some Central Asia instrument and a West Asia instrument. Yes, I want to test, so I buy the cheaper one. Of course, the cheaper one is very bad quality. And okay, next one I want to introduce is very special instrument. It's my one of favorite instruments. That sounds great. This one instrument is very big. Let's see. It's long neck. Just like a three-string instrument in Sanxian, but this one only two strings. Of course, those kind of instruments original is adapted from a plucked instrument. So because I already put the phone on the fireway, but it's still hard to cover everything. Because the string is very long, I think it's about 70 centimeter, I think, from the Yueshan to the bridge. 70 centimeters. Yeah. The bow also big. Original, this instrument only has two strings. You know, in China we call it Dalei or Leiqin. And some instruments are similar as this called Zhuihu. Zhuihu also have two strings, but the soundbox, the resonator, the smaller. The soundbox is made of brass, so the sound's very powerful. Because the distance is very long, so the string sounds like a kind of a weaker instrument called sitar. Yeah, sitar. It's one string instrument, but this one have three strings, two strings plus a bass. So it's very special design. So you can see the bridge, the two is lower, the one is high. Yeah. Okay, I'll just say improvisation to something on the instrument to show you the difference between the three instruments. Thank you. traditionally, you know, this instrument mostly uses one finger to play. But I try to combine some Erhu skills on this. It sounds beautiful, you know, I love it. And especially the sound, because the stream. So when I play the Erhu, I also move the changing a little bit high, try to make the string have a more distance. Of course, if you move changing up, the string will be tight if you want tuning the standard D and A. So my Erhu sometimes tuning C and a G. I researched many traditional pieces played by folk musicians. They tune the strings, sometimes CG, yeah, not DA. DA, I believe this kind of tuning standard is from a Western orchestra. So if we copy everything from orchestra, symphony orchestra, of course, DA and GD, so that's standard. That's why we can find that there are many folk string instruments, not a tuning that kind of standard. Okay, so we can see the QIN Erhu, extended and arranged Erhu, and Zhonghu, and Dalei. So you can see the different kind of instruments have different size, the neck, and also different distance from the yuesheng to the bridge. Of course, cause the sound different. But if we want to play a good sound to make the instrument enjoyable, of course, you have to control your bow, by my suggestion, 3 points. Yeah, if we can control the bow well, of course, this hand also need to cooperate together, not just floating on the air, okay? So this one, sometimes you just like to play harmonic, not press too much. Sometimes you need more energy. Erhu too, okay? Okay, today I want to introduce Erhu from Wangguoxing. And this instrument, some people call it Zhuchangyao style. If you search the website, you can find many videos of Zhuchangyao. He changed the size from the big one to smaller one to play some South Yangtze River, old Jiangnan and South Yangtze River. Starts music. Erhu is on sale, so if you are interested in this Erhu, please send an email to me. And I have some different kind of styles Erhu in stock. And I used to sell instruments when I come to the United States, but I still have a lot in stock. If you are interested, I have wind instruments, I have string instruments. Feel free to contact me. I would like to answer your question. So anyway, if you have a question about all the instruments, feel free to contact me.